Okay, if we have already designed yesterday, today we are going to present project work. The title is Autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, and today our whole group are going to present their project one after another. Therefore, you have to be ready with the finishing part of the project work. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
All the groups are ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. First of all, I am going to call you one after another. You have to come here and present very nicely. Okay? And group number one, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, from group number one, there are Bhagavan, Meghraj, Vishal, Rashmi, Ankita and Sushmita, they are going to present their the final report of project work. Please, you are welcome. To...
Good afternoon, everyone. Today I am here to present our final result of our project on the topic of an autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. Sir, I'm going to study. The former president of India, Abdul Kalam, was born on 15 October 1931, was hardworking patriotic person. An autobiography of Abdul Kalam 1999 was written by Abdul Kalam himself and Arun Tiwari on the subject of India's journey to self-reliance in technology. Dr. Kalam was an outstanding student from his early childhood. He was always interested in scientific research and experiment. He examines his early life, effort, hardship, fortitude, love, and chance, which eventually led him to lead Indian space research, nuclear and missile programs. Him, a renowned aerospace scientist, started his career after graduating from aerospace engineering in MIT, Chennai, India at Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. He was also elected as 11th Prime Minister, called People's President of India, while supported by both Indian National Congress and Bharatiya Party. He led Indian nuclear weapons program with success in thermonuclear and weapons development. A successor in all fields, he was involved that while delivering a lecture at the Indian Institute of Management, collapsed and died from an apparent cardiac arrest on 27 July 2015, aged 83, leaving us all deeply sad. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. After the presentation, I'd like to ask you some questions. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, from this group. Okay, Pushpa, when was APJ Abdul Kalam born?
Abdul Kalam was born on 15 October 1931.
Okay, is she correct?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Similarly, from this group, group 4. Okay, Rasa, when did he die?
He died on 27 July 2015.
Okay, is she correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And from this group, yeah, Prashant?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you tell an important award about him?
Bharat Ratna Award.
Oh, Bharat Ratna. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, what? Okay, give them a big hand, okay? Yes. Is designed to present their project work. Now it's turn of group 4. From group 4, there are different students. They are coming here for their presentation. Please, you are welcome to the stage.
Good afternoon, everyone. Is the guys of group 1 give a fine presentation on the autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. The guys, I mean we group 4, I mean the group 4 also giving a sweet short and totally source information about the autobiography of Sir APJ Abdul Kalam. So let me start it. Abdul Kalam, full name Abul Pakir Jalaluddin Abdul Kalam, who was born on 15th October 1931, is a former president of India, also known as People's President, awarded by Bharat Ratna, is India's highest civilian honor. He was graduated from Aerospace Engineering of MIT, Chennai, India. During 1990s and early 2000s, Kalam moved to DRDO to lead the Indian weapon program with particular successes on thermonuclear weapon. He pioneered the first space launch vehicle program. He, along with his friend Arun Tiwari, also wrote a book named Wings of Fire. He was a very respected person leading India to its first rocket launch. A very kind hearted person thinking about the happiest and prosperous future of children and living simply and thinking highly, Abdul Kalam died on 27 July 2015 at Shillong, Meghalaya. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much. And I'd like to ask some questions to the other group. Okay? Are you ready?
Yes.
Alright. Now, Pujan?
Yes, sir.
You get married?
No.
No. Okay. It means you remain?
Single.
Single for his life. Okay. Thank you. And what was their most striking point? It means they, while presenting, what did they do very well? Bhagwan, give your opinion.
Their opinion was fine.
No.
And
okay, very fine presentation.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Okay, and now you are satisfied with their presentation?
Yes.
Okay. So, why are you late to give them big hand? Okay, similarly, I'd like to request another group for the presentation. And our title is same, and it is like a competition. Which group is going to do very well? Okay, just now, I'd like to call group number two for their presentation about the autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam, and they are ready to come here. Please, welcome to the stage.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are beginning with our results of project work of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. We were six friends in our project work, and our project was like this. Your dream have to dream before your dreams can come true. Autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. Every person who are born are capable of doing any heroic deeds in his or her life. Among millions of people are really born or two are capable of doing heroic deeds. Among the famous personalities, the Indian's 11th president APJ Abdul Kalam was one of them. Abdul Kalam was born in Rameswaram, India, is 15th October 1941. As a child, had dreamed to be an aerospace engineer. Due to his hard work, he was able to reach his goal and success. Dr. Kalam examines his early life, efforts, hardship, fertility, luck and chance that led him to lead India. Later, he moved to ISRO and helped establish the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center and pioneered the first space launch vehicle program. During the 1990s and early 2000s, Kalam moved to the DRDO to lead the Indian nuclear weapons program with particular success in thermonuclear weapons. On 27th July 2015, while delivering speech on 10 a.m., APJ Abdul Kalam died from heart attack. Dream is not what you see in sleep. While sleep, it is the thing which doesn't lead to sleep. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your very good presentation. Okay, and especially in this group, how many of you were there? Please tell the name.
We were six friends in our group. Sunita Shrestha, Sushma Gandhi, Sudip Shrestha, Amit Tamang, Prasant Mohan, and Vinny Sajari.
Okay, and yes, are you satisfied with the presentation?
Yes.
Okay, and from this presentation, I'd like to ask you some questions, okay? And just now, okay, from this group, Susmita, Okay. Yes. What was his nationality? It means where was he born? Can you tell me?
His nationality was
India. India. It means Asian, Indian. Okay, you are an Indian. Oh, very good. Thank you. Sit down. Okay, and from this group, Dosan. Okay, and why did your what was the cause of his death?
The cause of his death was cardiac arrest.
Okay, and when did he die?
He was dying on July 2015.
Okay. Thank you very much. And from this note, what did they do very well according to your view? Krishna, what did this group do very well? Some exciting point.
Their beginning is very
exciting.
And I like this presentation the way.
The way of presentation. Yeah. Very good. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, thank you. Give them a big hand. Yes, and just now, three presentations are way over. Now the presentation of group number?
Three.
Okay, and group three, students are presenting their report based on the autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. And you are welcome to the stage. Please come here and present your.
Good afternoon everyone, today we are here to present our report on autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam, and let's go. The former president of India, Dr. Abdul Kalam, was born on 15 October 1931. He was one of the activists from inside, especially in the area of education and science. He examined his army life in Fort Arcee, fortitude, love in science that eventually lead him to lead nuclear and missiles program. He completed his graduation from Aerospace Engineering, MIT China, India, at Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. After moving to ISRO and ELP, he established the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center. He pioneered the first space launch vehicle program. He was assigned to build a aircraft
Pandey, Farvin Powder, and Sudip Padar, and it's me.
Okay, thank you very much.